Today's video is dedicated to people who believe in freedom! Freedom from science! Greg Shapiro here, the American Netherlander, with an excerpt of my show, Leaving Trumpland, Make America Democracy Again. So, Trump is already conducting live, in-person campaign rallies to run for president in 2024, and American health experts are just sitting there on the sidelines, yelling into the wind, "Stop! You'll kill yourselves! Please, don't!" Anthony Fauci is there like Willy Wonka. Somebody do something! Help! Call the police! And now that Donald Trump is back on the campaign stump, he needs a new Hillary, and guess who he's picked? Anthony Fauci. Yes, he's been going after Fauci ever since he was still tweeting. You know, putting out tweets like, "He's so short, I don't know how anyone can trust him. And did you see him throw out the first pitch at that baseball game? He didn't even come anywhere near home plate." And Anthony Fauci with the perfect comeback. "That's my job, to make sure nobody catches anything." Dr. Fauci was actually in Amsterdam to speak in 2019, and at the time, I didn't know who he was, but he's been on the front lines of every viral outbreak since HIV/AIDS in the 80s, and on stage, he made this prediction. He said, "Every president so far has had some kind of viral outbreak on his watch. I would not be surprised if President Trump has to deal with this too." So he basically predicted COVID. Then come my friends on Facebook who were like, "Oh, coincidence? Did he predict the pandemic or did he plan it? That's why it's a plandemic." Yeah, man, it's true. I did my own research. Did, meaning watched, my own, meaning someone else's, and research, meaning crappy YouTube video. I mean, this stuff sneaks up on you. Sometimes your friends start spouting these conspiracy theories, like at my daughter's birthday party. It got so awkward, I had to change the subject to Zwarte Piet just to relieve the tension. And before Dr. Fauci, there was Bill Gates, who gave his TED Talk in like 2015, predicting some global pandemic. And of course, everybody was like, "Oh, he planned it. That's Bill Gates' secret agenda. He wants to inject us with the mind control microchips." And if that's true, then hey, I'm old enough to remember when they had to inject you with a whole floppy disk. I mean, think about it. That must have been painful. But hey, if you're going to connect all the dots, why stop at 2019 or 2015? Why not go all the way back to the year 2011 and the Steven Soderbergh film called Contagion? We saw this movie pass by on our Netflix menu, and, you know, it was under the category disaster movies. My wife, she loves disaster movies because of escapism. And I thought, I don't know, I think we've been living that movie for the past year or so. Okay, so we pressed play on Steven Soderbergh's Contagion from 2011, and oh my wow, was this movie hilarious! For all the wrong reasons. I mean, first of all, the premise is, okay, this is gonna sound crazy, but like, what if there's a pandemic that kicks off so fast and exponentially that society shuts down, there's like panic buying and looting at the shops, and instead of, oh, I was like, aww. And the pandemic, it starts in China from like the wildlife in China. I was like, wait, what year did you make this? And okay, this is gonna sound the hardest to believe, but what if even though people are like dying all over the place, there are certain people in America who don't trust the government, they think it's all a hoax, and they refuse to follow the health and safety guidelines. I was like, yeah, that's happening right now. Shocking, but not surprising. And Gwyneth Paltrow is in the movie Contagion. She plays one of the anti-vaxxers who's like, "We just need to boost our immune system. I'm gonna put a jade egg in my vagina." And sorry, that's not Gwyneth Paltrow from the movie, that's just Gwyneth Paltrow from real life. But in the movie, spoiler alert, Gwyneth Paltrow ends up being patient zero because her character signs a business deal that results in deforestation, which results in a bat, yes, a bat, having to fly out of its habitat, infect a pig. The pig is slaughtered by the chef. The chef infects Gwyneth Paltrow, and she gets on an airplane and infects the entire planet. They straight up predicted COVID in 2011. Or did they plan it? Because Gwyneth Paltrow had to go to China for the filming of the movie. And what else comes from China? Jade. That's how Gwyneth Paltrow got the jade egg to put in her vagina. And now she's selling it on her group website for how much? $66. As in 666, the number of the devil. Coincidence? And Gwyneth Paltrow also sells her vagina candle. Candle as in candle in the wind, as in the song Elton John sang at the memorial for who? Princess Diana, which just goes to prove that Gwyneth Paltrow killed Lady Di. So yes, that is basically how you conspiracy theorists sound to me, especially you holistic thinkers out there. Everything happens for a reason. Everything bad that happens, it must be the result of someone's evil plan. Me, I prefer just to remember Hanlon's razor, which states, "Never attribute to malice that which is adequately explained by stupidity. Act in defiance. Embrace science!"